Well, we are starting up quite geared. I've found some good loot, found some not food but just fruits. Still a bit low on water, and I have not a clue where I'm going as I'm very new to this game. DayZ, played on a PS4 Pro, recorded on AVerMedia 2 Plus live gaming portable. It's a portable capture card which can be used both to PC and Mac computers. Just going to follow this road. I am still haven't met a single nice player in this PS4 community. I've been shot every single time I approached someone. Trying to speak, but I'm getting shot at pretty much straight away. And since it takes me a little while to get my guns out and stuff like that, it usually ends with me getting killed. I'm not sure, but I might be heading up to a castle. Or not, this is just a hunting stand. But I've been up to a castle before, a hill or a mountain, what do you call it? Seen a few videos on this on YouTube, but I'm not sure if the spawn is the same on PS4 as it is on PC. Usually you get some good in a hunting stand, and this was not very good. Let's head over this way. Of course, I think it's very good to know the map. You can download the map on your computer or your phone. Still, if you don't know the general directions and stuff like that, it's going to take you a while to get it sorted out. So let's have a pair while we're jogging down here. I heard a moose before, or a deer. I haven't been able to see it with my eyes so I can shoot it yet. Probably quite a lot of food on an animal like that. So I have to decide if I want to go left or right. Let's see here if I didn't have... I had a map probably on the last character who got killed by... Thing is, shall I follow the road or continue down the hill? I'm just heading down the hill instead. Let's go this way. You can find compasses, which is good because then you know which direction you're running. Now you know your direction, but then you knew compass, you start to know your headings around this map. We have the road to our left here. Just following it. I usually, because I don't know the map, I try to follow roads and power lines just to get my bearings. Double tap L1 and you zoom in. Zombies over there. I think we need to go check that place out. Mostly because I am here and don't have so much to do. I need to polish my Russian. Is the hatchet better? I'd rather use melee weapons because I don't have a gun with a silencer. To put away the baseball bat for some reason. We're in a hospital. It's pretty understandable what you can actually get shotgun shells here as well. I don't have a shotgun, right? I picked something up now, that's why I can't put it away. To sort this out. Six. So I got 8. Yeah, like that. So it's a bit of a hassle to keep your inventory straight, but it, after a while, it kind of makes sense how you work it. Just need to be safe when you start working with it, so you don't get a zombie that jumps you in the middle of the inventory. Looks like I have. Oh, nice. As well as I need to fill. Sorry for the still having. Don't drink it. Empty it. When you find a bottle, you should. Oh, a lot of zombies. When you find a bottle, you should always empty it before you fill it up with the water, because you never know who, what people put in bottles and stuff. To take them out one by one. Yeah, come over here. Yes, he saw me. And he, of course. Cool. See if you can see. See if we can grab the binoculars. No, we do not pick anything up in our hands because of that zombie over there. Sometimes I see you straight away. Oh, there's a compass and box rounds. I think I can put away the baseball bat. Good to know and to think where have you been and where you should go and sort out everything with the loot. As you can see here, I carry way too much crap. Road flare, not sure I'm never gonna use it. A bunch of magazines, one light. Can't Yeah, so it's a little bit of a hassle to 63. How much do I have in this? Oh, 80 in the backpack, so it's no point for me picking that up. Hunting knife, finally I got a knife. A PU scope. I'm not sure if. Can't put a scope on either of these rifles for some reason. But I prefer to drop that and pick the PU scope up. Just in case I find a gun that can use a scope. I've never used a scope, so always time for first. Not sure if this is fruit trees, but that's how I kept myself alive for a while now. Just scavenging fruit. And I have a pear left, that's it. Some more before we leave here. Yeah, I can't carry the binoculars at the moment, but I'm sure I need to because I have so much other crap. Like probably magazines and stuff that I'm never going to be able to use. So okay, there's one. Did you see me? Or there was an encounter with a hospital. And we keep on heading this way. I choose a server that's low. There's not so many people on it. Just because I'm new to the game and trying to learn the menus and stuff like that, but still, even on a server with a low amount of people, it's still I still have some encounters. Winter jacket, pick it up and check best insulation and the high insulation. So we drop our coat and we equip our jacket and voila, we suddenly have more we can pick up even more stuff with this hunter jacket, which is white, not exactly the best in a green environment, but some water, I have a pear, this way. I'm gonna do a little. Yeah, like that. Because the carbine, I still don't have any bullets, so I don't know why it. I don't know why it is equipped, actually. Yeah, it's because to get more space in inventory. So having a single shot rifle with plenty of ammunition, but no scope on it. Another house up there? Yeah. Let's head up there. And I have a lot of magazines and a lot of bullets, but no bullets for the actual repeater rifle, which I think is better than the other crappy rifles that I've been finding. If you have a map, you can of course read the signs and realize where to go much quicker. There's a house up there. Wasn't it a house there? Oh, look at the car. So we head up to this little village and still haven't found any meat. Like, yeah, I found one chicken and tried to hit it with a baseball bat, and the lag was really funny. Yeah, I do not want cheap metal. You can actually build bases and stuff, but I'm just trying to learn the basics here, so no base building or anything like that for me. Raincoat. We have a cool white hunter's jacket. I think we're heading into the village, right? We're taking the houses on the way there to just check them out. Oh, it's locked. So, question is someone hiding inside, or is it just. Oh, so yeah, he's out of stamina. So can't jump. So it's just one door in. Let's see if we can do this. Huh! Yeah, you could. And bang, I get shot. Oh, box. Now let's see here. Go. Thank you for the hatchet. We need to open the menu and open. Is it those rounds? Box 3. Put them in the hands. We keep in R2, and it's 20 bullets. And then I go to my repeater carbine and hold triangle. So now it's fully loaded. Nice. So for that we got a box of bullets, which was good. We get some paper, we can use that in case we're going to start a fire somewhere. I'm not sure why the both doors were locked. If anyone been there and locked it, or I'm not sure why, but you can use a hatchet to crank it open. So when we take out the carbine, we can aim it, or we can aim it like this. Makes a hell of a noise though when you fire it, so... hiking pants. The magazine, yeah. We grab... We're like the magazine carrier. I hear a chicken. That would be nice. Just heard it once, so... Just gonna go through it quick and see. I don't have a Colt. I think that's a sporter. Oh, that's SK. That is. Rifle, yeah, we have to drop that. It's a Sportster and a Sportster. Am I carrying? Yeah. You really need to stay attention to the details. Trying to hunt some chicken now. somewhere. Shoot it. Yeah. No, I do not want to dig up. Yes, you can see I'm still learning the these two. Skin and quarter. Chicken steak. And grab. And now it's good because we have gloves on, so we have no worries about getting sick from chicken. Having some bark. Thank you. Sure what he's doing, but he's fixing the firewood. Sure stick. Sure we have any matches, so okay, I can't carry the knife at the moment. The hatchet. Sorry. Hopefully this place has a had a fireplace. The only place I didn't have a fireplace. Okay, I have a building with no fireplace. I can see the chimney on that one, so I need to remember to bring the hatchet. choosing to craft a drill kit because I don't have a lighter. Putting on a few extra sticks of wood and I'm taking the chicken and start to cook it. So some ACP rounds over here. Thing is, it goes quite quick to get it to cook. So you can actually see here, about 100 degrees. It's still raw. And baked. Taking it back to the inventory. And it's baked. So we have some to go and get the hatchet then, so we don't forget it, because that's a good piece of equipment that I left up here somewhere. Zombie over there as well. I'm not sure if we did this house. I usually leave the doors open so I know I've been in there. Raincoat. Quite surprised that it hasn't started raining yet. Alcoholic tincture. Not sure if we're able to drink that or if it's just for show. Looks like quite a big town. I'm not sure how to approach this. If the zombies spawn more towards the center or just spread out. You can see a church over there. I can see another bigger building over there. Just surprised yet I haven't got killed by another player yet, but huh. some chicken steak there. Sweater, we do not need a sweater. Here comes the rain, of course. A raincoat. I can open. Yeah, grab it. As soon as it starts to rain, it gets cold. I'm not sure how long the rain will usually last for, but I think I'm going to call it a day with this short clip, which is the first in a series, I think. Trying to figure out DayZ and how to play it, what to do and what not to do, and well, just trying to stay alive, finding gear. Take care and have a good one. See you on the next one.